Hey, crafty friend. I'm Amanda with Pear Blossom Press. We're the guys who make the guts for light-up cards. I'm so excited to join you today in the Spellbinders Creative Classroom, where I will show you how to pair our lights with some fun new birthday dies from Spellbinders. We're going to make a birthday card featuring our halo light, and then also one of our one lights. If you haven't seen our lights before, this is the halo light combo. You can find that in the Spellbinder shop. Inside, you'll get six lights. They just snap apart. Each one in the center has two additional lights, and these guys just pop right out. They come with batteries. You can peel them out and install them, the shiny side up, and then press the button and they light up. Can you see that? This is a halo light. Like I said, in the center, you get two additional one lights, and they each have one light bulb. So I'll insert a battery, and then this is the button down here, the little gold button. And can you see it light up? So both of them are basically flat little flashlights. They're easy to sandwich into your cards and add lights. Let me show you the die sets that we'll be pairing them with today. And I'll slide these out of the way. The brand new Build-A-Wreath set from Spellbinders is really beautiful. You can make some pretty flowers. It's got a gorgeous bow. And then you've got lots of branch options. There are add-on sets, and we'll be playing with the birthday wreath add-on set today. But let me show you. In addition, I've got some samples at the end that I'll show you too. There's a Halloween add-on, Christmas, and then even this beautiful garden wreath add-on. Now, mind you, yours won't come chewed up by your pet rabbit like mine did, but she likes to get up in the couch and cut paper with me. We will also be using the infinity or everlasting circles here too, because we need a circle die to cut out the window for our halo. And then just released are the take action sentiment stamps, because you're going to want something that says push or press, so that your recipient will know where to press the button. Bling is always a good thing, so I'm going to bring in some little gems at the end, and then you're going to want your double thick foam tape. Now this is twice as thick as regular foam tape, and you want that so that you have the same thickness as your light, so that your card front will be nice and even, and I'll show you that as we get going. So let's go ahead and start with the halo light card. Okay, just move this stuff out of the way. So we'll work with the halo first. If I have a couple different card pieces already cut so that I can show you. I've got an A2 card base for this particular card. I've got two panels of heavy white cardstock. These are trimmed down to 3 7/8 by 5 1/8 so that we'll have a nice little border. But I have two panels because these lights are nice and bright, and we wouldn't want them to bleed through too much where we don't want it to. So I'm going to double that up for us. It also makes your card feel a little thicker and more stable. Now from the Build-A-Wreath die set, I have gone ahead and cut four of these little white branches. You can obviously cut them from any color you like. One of my favorite things to do is to cut all of the pieces from white cardstock and then color them with my Olo markers. But in this case, we're going to keep it simple and no coloring today. So I've cut four branches for you. And then from the birthday set, we're going to piece together a few different things. I'm just using shades of pink, light and dark pink, and then gold, because I thought that would be a pretty pop. So you can see we've got all of the pieces cut out to make the bow, the packaging, and the box itself. Those will all assemble. I've already cut the balloon. I do want to show you, there's this really cute little highlight, and I will show you a trick to get that lined up perfectly. And then for the hat itself, you'll notice that the dies have a solid layer, and then you have a couple of interchangeable drop-ins. So I cut a solid one from white, and then I cut it again with the stripe drop-in from light pink, dark pink, and gold so that we can build a couple. But when you do this, you'll be able to make two or three different hats at the same time. So we'll piece that together in a second. And then I went ahead and I cut the accent pieces for the hat in sparkly gold. And I cut the sentiment twice. You can do it more times if you'd like, but I want it at least two times thick because it's going to float across the opening of the halo, and we'll want to make sure that it's rigid. So at least two times. And I do have a trick, since the B is not connected to the rest of the word, I have a trick to layer those up and glue them so that it will not be a weird bump. It'll be nice and smooth. So I'll show you that in 1 second too. Okay. So let me show you how to cut that balloon highlight and get that lined up first, because it's kind of nifty. You can see I've got extras from the last part. So the balloon itself, there's a solid piece, and then there's the drop-in. I've already cut the balloon from dark pink. This time, all I really need is the little highlight. And if you're frugal with your cardstock like I am, especially the specialty papers, you don't have to cut the whole thing. You can just kind of get it lined up to the edge so that it's there. And did you notice Spellbinder's gold mirror cardstock and the brushed gold on both sides cuts like butter. And if you're doing anything where you might need to see the backside and you want it metallic, this is the paper. Let me bring the die cutting machine closer. I love it when it sticks to my top plate because then it all stays together. So notice that the gold pieces are in the die. Can you see that? That's what we want, because this way we can add a little bit of glue right here while it's still in the die. Whoops, and it stuck to my glue, the little piece, but that's okay. I'll put it right back. And then when I flip it over, and it doesn't play nice. When I do this at home, it always works. Let's try that again, and let me give it a little more glue. I do like Barely Arts for the metallic papers like this because they are slightly plasticky, and Barely Arts holds nice for that. Then I'm going to take my pokey tool and just poke through. Do you see how this is now lined up with that whole big balloon? And then when I pull it away, it's perfectly positioned on your balloon. So you don't have to worry about how do I get there just right. You can do the same thing with sentiments if you're struggling with those. Okay, so that's my trick for those guys. Next up, let's go ahead and assemble the pieces. We've got our balloon assembled. We'll put the present together because I want you to see how the parts go together. They are quite adorable. And I'm just going to put the lid on the box. I cut that from a light cardstock, light colored pink. And then I'm putting it on top of, I've got it upside down here. Got it on a dark colored box base. And you can change these colors if you want a masculine card. Maybe something in the blues and greens, but feel free. I'm going to take this big, it's kind of a geometric U, but this is the ribbon that wraps around the box. Line it up, pop it in place. If it's not perfect at the top, nobody will ever see because the bow is going to cover that up. So make sure your bottom is lined up perfect, and then you can wiggle the top if you need to. Glue that down. These two little ribbon pieces stick out from the bow or from under the bow. And I like that they have little dots, little circles at the end. So I'm going to glue those guys together And then I can glue these to the package. Oops, wasn't quite set up just yet. That's okay. Barely Arts takes a little bit longer, but it holds better for plasticky stuff, for your gems and for things like that. Well, maybe I'll just use more glue. When in doubt, add more glue, right? I'll give that a second to set up. Okay. And then for the bow, you can see that the smaller piece matches identically if you wanted to use different colors. But if you want it to look more full, just give it a slight little twist like that. And then you have a bow that looks even more full when you glue it together. So I'm going to add plenty of glue on the back of this. And give it a slightly offset twist. And then we'll glue this together as well. And because this glue takes a little longer to dry, we'll let that sit for a second while we assemble the hat. So I've cut a white base, and then I'm going to use the light pink colored frame. Line that up just like that. And then we can take two each of the gold and hot pink stripes. And I'm being generous with the glue again, as we've learned I should, for the gold. Wouldn't it be fun to do this in a whole rainbow of colors? I think so. Oh, we don't need a light pink, we need the dark pink. And then I've cut the ruffly little bottom from gold glitter, which is really cute. Now, this is not double-sided, which is fine. It actually makes the glue stick faster, like regular paper. Oops, I think I over-glued. There we go. And then for the top of the hat, I've got this dark pink little guy here, and a gold little topper. There we go. I'll glue those together and then glue them on top. And yes, I do have tweezers right in front of me. I'm not sure why I'm not using them. Just one of those days. Okay. Cute little hat, right? Shiny and ready for the party. Okay, I promised to show you the sentiment trick, so let me do that. For the word birthday, the B is not connected, but we want to stack this up. So we would glue the word, the rest of the word together, and then we would glue the B together. But if we overlapped them, then you would have two layers connected on top of two other layers, so you'd have a big bump. So what I tend to do for this is I glue one layer to itself, the rest of the word to itself, and then I will glue the top B on top and the second B on the very back of the stack, and that will give you a smoother ride without a big bump changing from the B to the I. Now I will use those tweezers. I only need a little bit of glue on the lower cup of the bee.
Great.
And then I'll flip the whole thing over, and now we can add glue to this entire bee. And then sandwich the two eyes in there. And now the word is all connected and it's smooth instead of a big bump moving over to the rest of the word. For the word happy, it's all one piece, so we'll just glue that together as one. Okay, so now we have all of our pieces assembled, and I have four of those white branches. Now we can start working on the card base and add the lights. So I'll set these guys aside. Now I've got the card panel. Remember, that's a top fold A2. I'm going to set that aside, and I have these two panels. They're 3 7/8 by 5 1/8. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold them together, just basically hand sandwiching them. And then I'm going to grab circle dies, these guys here. And I need to find the circle that is roughly the same size as our halo, the opening in the center of our halo. So it's roughly 2 inches. So this one looks like the right one. So what I'm going to do is, holding these guys sandwiched together, not gluing them together yet, because just in case I need to take the top layer off, I'll be able to cut through the second layer. So I'm holding them together, and actually I want a little bit of tape. This makes life easier so things don't shift while you're die cutting, right? And I'm just kind of placing it roughly equal distance from the top and the two sides, so it's going to be slightly up on the card itself. And I will feed it back through. And remember, I'm just holding those two layers. You don't need to tape those two layers together. When we run it through the machine, if it doesn't cut through both layers at the same time or the first time around, then I can pull the top layer off. It will definitely leave an imprint in the bottom layer, and then we can run it through again if we need to. A lot of times it does cut all the way through though. So let's see. Oh, yep, we got all the way through. Perfect. I'm going to return this guy to the die set so I don't lose him. That would be a bummer. And then now what I'll do is go ahead and glue these two layers together. In fact, I think I'm going to make this one the top one because it's prettier. Okay. So now we have our card front and our card base. And what we want to do is determine roughly where the light is going to sit. And I've already made this card before, remember, in our sample. So I know that I want the button to live somewhere down here. Remember, this is the button here. And what I'm doing is figuring out where we want to stamp the word push. And I think that works. You can always lay out your pieces and figure out where there would be space in there. But remember, I've already made this, so I know it works right there. We'll bring in the Misty. So I'll go ahead and line this up in here. And I do have the light on top just for now because I want to show you where to place the button. We'll bring in the take action sentiments. I think we're going to go with, let's go with press. That's a nice small one here. And so I'm going to kind of line it up on the button. It doesn't have to be perfect, but when I close the lid, I can pick it up. And then it's in just the right spot. I'll move the light out of the way. Make sure we're good here. And then I can bring in some pink ink to match the pink of the decorative elements. Just give a light press. If you need to stamp twice, feel free to do that, but it's always better to do that twice with a gentle pressure than it is to give CPR and then the word becomes hard to read. So we've got the word press here. I'll set this aside for now. Isn't that cute? I don't want to lose that stamp. I'll put that back, but we'll use it for the next card in a second. Okay, so now we can go ahead and attach our light to the back side. And what I like to do is use double stick tape and just go straight across that battery clip. You can obviously add to the back, which we will, but if you want to line it up from the back side rather than trying to figure out where to put it on your card base instead, this is an easy trick to do that. So see how I've pulled off the release paper? This is my button, and obviously we'll match up the holes. So I'm going to slide it behind. And then I'll give it a test until the button is in just the right spot, the lights are in just the right spot, and I like that. And then I can move my finger over and catch the double-sided tape. So now it's adhered. See that? Very simple. If you wanted to, you could make that a shaker pouch by putting some acetate there before you put the light in. That's up to you, but we're not making a shaker card today. I thought I'd keep it as simple as possible. And I'm just going to add a little bit more double stick tape here. And you can even add it around the edges. You don't have to do a whole lot, just a couple spots to keep it sticking to your card base once we pull it up. And any that hangs off the edge, I'll just fold back on itself because it is sticky. So see how these edges stick out? Just fold them back a little bit. There you go. And now, before we adhere it to our card base, we want to use that double thick foam tape. Remember, the double thickness is to get the same height as the battery. This is a brand new roll. If you don't have double thick foam tape, just use two layers of regular. And I'm going to go ahead and stick it down. Kind of around the perimeter of my card here. And then maybe two more little pieces. Okay, now we can peel up the release paper for these guys and then stick it to our card base. Here we go. Just like that. Now we've done the hard part of making a light up card. All we have left to do is decorate. I've got these fun little white branches. I thought tone on tone would be pretty. And instead of making a full circle all the way around, I'm going to make it roughly 3/4. And I'm going to save one to add as extra filler. But you'll notice that all of these guys, all of the branches are going in the same direction. They're kind of curved this way. If I start with this guy here, it's sort of the edge. So what I want to do is just train him back the other direction. And then he won't be perfect, but that is not a problem at all. It'll look better. It'll look more full. But this way, when we glue him down, he's going to go the opposite direction, and then the full branches are heading toward the edges. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm just adding glue. It doesn't have to be everywhere, but to the center of the branch. I'll hold it for a second to let it adhere. One more going in the same direction. It is a fun card to play with. Okay, and then this is the one we were correcting and changing direction on. So I'm going to just do the same thing along the seam or along the center. And remember, if it's not perfect, don't worry, because you are going to be adding decorative elements on top of that. So I'm not worried if it's not perfect. I'm just going to give it 1 second. This one wants to kind of curve back to its original shape, so I'll let the glue hold up. There we go. Now one more for filler, but we'll add that at the end. So these guys will just glue down. Then I think I want to tuck the balloon in a little bit like that. I want to make sure not to cover up the word press. And I'm going to let my balloon stick up a little bit off the edge, kind of nestled underneath one bit of the branch and sticking off the top edge there. Still doesn't extend beyond the card, so it will go into its envelope nicely, but it kind of comes up off of its base a little. And then we've got our birthday hat here. That stick up. Okay, now the words happy birthday. They're more rigid. You could even do a third layer if you want. It looks like I only need to do the D-A-Y because the rest will be floating. And I like this script because it doesn't have to be perfectly straight. Nobody will notice. It kind of has a bit of whimsy to it. Or you can take your ruler and make it perfect if you want to. All right, the tops of the H is going to catch. And a Y, I think. Oh, a little bit more. There we go. We'll line that up just a little bit. We'll let that glue dry. And then we have this last little guy. I'm going to trim him so that we make two branches out of this. Then I can tuck a little bit more in here and there. I think that will go there. And then this guy, I think I'll even make this two more pieces. Something like that. And like that. Like to give him a little test drive before I give him glue, just in case. And I'm letting it come over my present a little bit so that the wreath is still part of this. There we go. All it needs now are some gems, and this card will be done. I love these little crystal mixes. They are self-adhesive, and there's two different colors in this particular package. You've got a milky crystal, and then more of a silvery crystal. And I'm just going to be kind of random about it. And if you're happy with where they are, give them a firm press, and they're ready. You don't have to wait for glue to dry or anything. I think that's pretty. We've got our first card done. Give it a little press. Okay, now remember the inside of that halo light had a one light. So I'm going to show you how to use this in the other card that we'll make today. Okay. Again, I've got a card base with two white panels. These also measure 3 7/8 by 5 1/8 inch. The card base is a top fold A2. So set that aside. I've cut out three more of those white branches. These guys are gonna pretty much match. I've cut the birthday sentiment again. This one, you can just glue all the layers together. They're not gonna hang off the edge, so the bead does not have to be connected. We've got the cupcake parts. Cupcake is so fun in the birthday set. It's got frosting, the actual cake itself, and then the cupcake liner, which is embosses nicely. And then in addition, it has these kind of little sparklers instead of candles for a cupcake. I think that is just the cutest thing ever. In the Wreath Builder die set, you have lots of flower options. So I cut out one 2 times so that I can double it up, and then a little gold center. And then the bow itself has several parts. We've got the ribbon, we've got the wide piece that's a little bit longer from side to side, and then we've got the tall piece that layers on top, and then it even has the little knot over the front. And if you want, you could always add highlights or a little bit of ink blending, but I'm not going to today. I think it looks really cute just like it is. I've also got a circle of vellum. I think that was the second largest die here. And so I'm going to set that aside so we don't lose it. And we're not going to have to do any gluing together of these guys. So I'll set them aside for now too. And then I'm just going to glue these together for you real quick. Here's what I do with flowers to give them a little bit of life. You can always use the pad. But if you just run them on your thumb real quick, or the palm of your hand real quick, you're good. Glue these guys together and offset the petals. And then that pretty gold center will make this flower pop. For the bow, we'll just glue those layers together. It's nice because there's a big notch there, so you know exactly where to add your glue. And the dies themselves imprint with some pattern, which is pretty. And I'm only adding glue to that center so that I can fluff this bow if I want to. And then this guy, he's small. I need the tweezers for this one. And I'm just going to add the glue right to the bigger piece. That makes life easier. Oops, I think I have it upside down. Nope, I didn't. One more time. Here we go. There we are. And if you want to fluff it, you can kind of give it a little finger curl. And that'll just give your bow a little more life. There we go. It will smash back down in transit, but it'll want to come back to not fully flat. Okay, for the cupcake, I've got this pretty little craft cardstock, and then our hot and light pink again. Just gonna line it up. That cupcake gives you plenty of room to glue to. I thought this would be maybe a spice cake or a chocolate cake there in the craft color. Plus it works nicely with the gold tones. And then for our sparkler, I'm not going to glue the sparkler to the cupcake just yet, but I will. Okay, then we're going to glue the glittery sparkler top to the mirror paper base, just like this. And we're not going to glue it to the cupcake just yet. So we'll just let it sit for a second. And then we can glue our sentiment together. Again, I have two layers here. Feel free to use three or four, however thick you like your sentiments to be. One layer, I think, feels, it's fine, but one layer doesn't feel quite as nice and hefty as two to three, sometimes four layers. The Spellbinder's cardstock is nice and thick, so when you layer it together, it starts to feel substantial quickly, which I always appreciate. And they have a beautiful range of colors. Okay, our pieces are ready. Now let's work on the base itself. What I want to do is kind of line everything up and kind of figure out where I want the push button to be and where I want the light to be. So I know I'm going to take these three sprigs and kind of do this with them. So as my friend Nancy says, we're going to audition everything right now, see if they're in the right space. I'm happy or totally fine if the words cover some of these sprigs, but they don't have to. And I want my cupcake roughly here. The flower will go on one side, the bow will come here. And then our sparkler is going to be where the light is. So what we're doing now is figuring out where the light will be and where the word push will go. And the word push needs to go this far away from the light bulb itself. So what I do is I kind of lay it on top, and I know I can put the word up here. I haven't covered it, so that will work for me. And I know that that will work as well. Okay. In the die set, we've got this little loose guy. He is the sparkler tip, but he's what we're going to use to make the hole for behind the light. So what I'm going to do is kind of put him down right there. Then I can move everything else out of the way. And I'm going to grab that tape again. I just need a tiny little piece. As long as we're in the neighborhood, this will be good. And I do have those two layers, but we're going to cut a different hole out of the back layer. So first layer, we're just cutting the sparkler. Get him on the die cutting machine, run him through. And then I can remove this. Cycle one second. And now I'm going to line these two panels up together, grab my pencil, and then kind of mark the middle of that. Now when I bring in
one of these circles,
I can line it up here and get that out of the way for one second. And then I can put this through. And that's actually going to give us a nice glow behind the sparkler, because that one light is very bright. And so we're kind of creating a second window.
Okay.
So see how from the back you can see the through one hole to the second. Now we can go ahead and glue these together. And by having a second layer here, this will give us a little bit more of a light box or block, or the light will kind of block it in. That way it doesn't escape beyond where we want it to show. Okay, remember that vellum circle? We're going to glue that here as well. And I'm going to use tweezers for this. And this will help cast that glow too. All right, here's our panel. Now remember, we need to stamp the word push.
Time to
move everything. It's always the incredible shrinking desk, right? Bring the stamp positioner back. And this time, I'm going to line it up again on the button. But I didn't clean that stamp, so it's a risky business here. Clean it off here. That's not wanting to stand up. Stay where I put you. There we go. Now I can grab it, get the light out of the way. This time I'm going to make sure that the word is straight. I know it's in the right neighborhood. I just need to make sure that it is straight. That looks good. So I can ink it up. Remember, don't do CPR on small word stamps. Just stamp twice if you need to. There we go. And our stamping is done. No coloring, minimal stamping. Okay, so now we can go ahead and add the light to the back side, just like we did with the halo. We're gonna take some more of that double stick tape, put it right on the silver battery clip because that makes it easy to line it up from the back side. And I'm gonna make sure that the button is under the word press and the light bulb is right behind that star. So I'm gonna kind of flip everything over, hold it there. And that works, so I can squeeze the battery clip where the tape is. There we go. Now we need some more of that double thick foam tape. Panel. And I want to show you on the back of the panel right here, if I put foam tape, we are really close to the edge there, so it would show, the foam tape would make a shadow. So I'm just going to come to here and then down here, and I will leave that edge open. It's not a problem. There's still plenty of support for your card. And that way you get less of a cast shadow. Do you love the new Spellbinder scissors? They're my favorite. So glad they're here. Okay, so remember, I'm not going to go too close. I'm going to come to the edge here, and then I can put a little more here if we want. I don't want to get too close because I don't want to create shadows for no reason. But now that I've cut this, might as well use it. Here we go. And before I take off that release paper, I'm going to double check. Okay, I don't see any shadows, so we're good to go. I can put a little bit of the double stick tape on here. Although it's really not necessary. And then we'll peel up the release paper of the foam tape. Whoops. If you do not have double thick foam tape, just go ahead and use two layers of regular foam tape because you want to get to the same height as that battery. Okay, we'll line it up here. There we go. And again, the hard part's done. Now it's just decorating. And you guys already saw me audition where everything's gonna go. I think I want it a little bit lower.
Seems good.
And in this case, I don't have to put glue all the way up the stem. I think I'll just put it on the lower half so that we can have a little bit of life. If these want to escape a little bit, or if we want to tuck anything under, we can. This glue does take a little bit to set up, but it's nice and strong once it does. Come across here. And then one more this way, I think. Maybe down a little lower. There we go. A cupcake, but I want to make sure the liner or the sparkler lines up here because we want that to look like it's glowing. So I'm going to go ahead and glue this first before the cupcake. Oh, I don't actually want glue on this part. I only want it on the bottom. Got ahead of myself. Wiped it off so that the top of the sparkler will not actually stick to the vellum. It's just going to kind of hover above. I'm just lining this up here. There we go. Now I can glue the cupcake in place. So that the sparkler looks like he's poking out. I'm going to put the bow down here, maybe at an angle. And I want to tuck this flower in. And then the sentiment to finish. Let's line this up first, make sure we like where it goes. Something along those lines. Okay. I'll do happy first since it's closest to the word press, and we need to make sure that we don't cover that up. So we can always work down, but not up if and cover the word. That would be bad. There, I like that. I kind of like it tucked underneath the cupcake a little bit. There we go. A few more gems, and this card is done. Let's see. Something up here. I like large and small next to each other. And then I tend to do groupings of maybe two or three, and then singles by themselves. This one, I think, since it's a, I'll do a cluster of three and it'll be small, medium, large. How's that? And then we'll draw the eyeball up. There we go. It's finished. So let's show you both of the cards. Our halo light here, the one light here. Remember, the halo light combo package comes with two halos and four of the one light, so you can make six different light up cards. And I am in love with the new wreath building die set. I did make some samples, and I'll show you again. The wreath builder, that big bow, some beautiful flowers, lots of different kinds of branches. So think all the holidays all year round. This is an evergreen set. You can use springtime, Halloween and fall, Christmas. They're all right there for you. The birthday add-on, of course, you can make birthday cards like we just did. So much fun. The garden wreath, even more flowering options for you, which I think these are quite beautiful. The season's greeting and the happy Halloween. And I will show you a couple sample cards that I made. So with the wreath builder itself, I just added a sentiment, but those flowers and the different sprigs are in there along with that bow. Isn't that pretty? And like I said, if you want, you can color your own die cuts. So I just cut these all from white cardstock and colored them. That's one of the things I like to do while watching TV. That has the halo inside. This card has a one light inside. And this is the Halloween add-on. I didn't even add any of the wreath guys here, but I just thought this was a fun little card here. And then for Christmas, another wreath for you. A little frosty. Super cute, right? It even has the greetings there for you. So be sure to check out our one lights. Be sure to check out the new wreath builder and the add-on sets. And we'll see you soon.